Happy New Year to all! And I hope you guys got some wonderful bookish and book items for Christmas. Obviously, I am wearing one of mine. Is this not great? My mother ordered this for me, and it's like, oh, you know, we all need shirts and sweatshirts with books on them. It's my first, like, article of clothing that has books on them, and I have seen some like wonderful bookish t-shirts out there, and I just don't own any. Oh, and can you see this? It's a little miniature book. I love them, and they're actually not that heavy at all. I thought, looking at them, I thought, oh, it's gonna be heavy, but it's not. And actually they're like really real, like little pages. Isn't that great? So, those are my two articles of clothing that I received for Christmas gifts. And then, check this out. Ready? Book lovers never go to bed alone. Never. And I like big books, and I cannot lie. I like big books, and I cannot lie. Yeah, I can't sing, but you get the drift. That's pretty awesome. I don't know what I'm going to do with these yet. It's almost like I don't want to mess them up. I just want to, like, have them. It's kind of like my books. I never dog ear my books. I never highlight in my books. I want them to look as new as when I got them. If they are new, anyway, in that case. But I did get, now I am a huge Disney fan, and I don't mind reading, you know, young adult, teenager type books, doesn't bother me, but As Old as Time. What if Belle's mother cursed the beast? Now, if you know the story of Beauty and the Beast, yeah, that is a big what if. Because you know, you read these stories, even these classics, and they don't always touch base on like what happened. Because obviously Belle, they don't, you know, her mother's not around. They really don't mention her, as in a lot of Disney stories. But you're always sitting there thinking, what if? What happened? Why did this lead up to this? Why didn't this lead up to this? Why didn't they elaborate on this certain character? So I am already on page 131 in this book, and other than the first chapter was kind of like, who are they talking about? What is going on? But after the first chapter, I have thoroughly enjoyed it so far. And it's rotating from one chapter is about the story of Belle's mother and father, you know, obviously before Belle was born. And then the next chapter will actually be basically the real, you know, Beauty and the Beast story of Belle's time. And it flip-flops back and forth. And so far the author has done a great job incorporating what you would think. Yeah, this is actually feasible. This could be really what happened. So enjoying the book so far. And then Letters from Yellowstone. This is a winner of the Pacific Northwest Booksellers Association Book Award for Fiction. It's by Diane Smith. This is the Penguin Reader's Guide. I mean, Penguin Edition. There's a Reader's Guide inside. And this is actually a used book. And this is always so sad, people. But it is inscribed, and it says, "Happy birthday, love Anne and Bob. Thought about you so much on our trip in Yellowstone." So whoever they gave this to, it's like, how did this end up in a secondhand store? And all my friends and family know, if you see a book in a secondhand store that you know I'm gonna like, anything on travel books, any type of traveling, I love. So, you know, he knew that I was gonna enjoy this book. But I sit here and think, how did they end up in thrift stores? This was somebody took the time to write a message to someone. This was a birthday present, obviously. And, you know, I can only assume that maybe they had taken a trip to Yellowstone with the person they gave this to. Or maybe the person always wanted to go to Yellowstone. Maybe they'd been several times and Ann and Bob had not. But it's just so sad. Sometimes I see these in there and it's like, what, did the person pass away and the family's donated all the books? That could happen. But there's always that, I'm just one of those people, like, whose book was this? What were they like? Did they enjoy it? Did they actually read it? And who is Bob and Ann? So, yeah, am I the only weird person that actually thinks about who owned the book before and what they thought about it and how the book ended up in a secondhand store? Yeah, it's the things I think about, people. That's probably why I love reading books, because my mind is always spinning on the what-ifs. So, not a lot of bookish items for Christmas. There's, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 items were it. But I always enjoy bookish gifts. Just love them. So please comment below on what books that you got for Christmas. And I'd like to also hear about what you guys are going to be reading this year. Because it might be something that I would want to pick up and read also into the next page.